Did you know there's a specific formula you can use to prompt ChatGPT and Gemini like a pro? Well, there is, and this is how to prompt an LLM. And don't just take my word for it. A lot of these tips come straight from Google. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and today I'm sharing a few prompt engineering tips so you can get the most out of your LLM of choice. And along with these prompt engineering tips, I'm going to share a prompt formula with you that can be used on any LLM you desire. Because the way you prompt your LLM makes a big difference in the quality of responses. Let's go! Now, before we jump into the five-part prompt formula and some examples, I've got some essential tips for you to keep in mind when you're prompting your LLM. First, be specific. Here's what I mean. When writing prompts, it's best to be as specific as you can. The more you go into detail, the more Gemini or ChatGPT or what have you will understand what you're asking for to give you a more informative response. So instead of saying something like, "Give me a list of names for my kitten," you could instead say, "Give me a list of 6 names for my gray and white tabby kitten." So the more detailed prompt you can give, the better the result. Prompt engineering tip number 2, paint a picture with your words. You can get really creative using either long or short prompts. It all depends on what you want to create. So here's how to know how much to write. Let's say you have a specific image in mind. You know what you want to create. Adding vivid details to your prompt can help Gemini or ChatGPT recreate what's in your imagination. So Google says that a short paragraph is the sweet spot. So it's got a lot of detail without being overwhelming. So if I know I want an image of a border collie through outer space, I could give a bunch of detail, like generate a photorealistic image of an adorable border collie zooming across a vibrant sky full of stars, leaving a shimmering trail of stardust behind. Okay. Not bad at all. It's given me a pretty well executed, almost exactly what I had in mind. But let's try this again and say that I'm more open to ideas and I need more help with the creativity aspect. So in this case, I'm gonna write just the basics and then I'm gonna let Gemini add its own creative spin. So for this one, I'll prompt, generate an image of a border collie traveling through space. And since I was more open to creativity here, you can see how Gemini has added its own dimensions to my prompt, and I've got a wider range of images to choose from. Prompt engineering tip number 3, ask follow-up questions. LLMs are built to build off of your prompts, so the more follow-up questions you ask, the better the responses can be. So for this example, I'm gonna try to pull information from my email and Gmail using Gemini extensions, which I have videos all about in the description below. I'm gonna ask Gemini, what dates did I go to Italy in 2017? Wow, so this is really good already. It's pulled the dates and corresponding emails for me. So now I'm gonna ask a follow-up of, show me where I stayed for those dates. And here it has pulled up where I stayed. It was basically all Airbnbs. And it's also pulled those corresponding emails where I could click through for details of those places if I wanted. You want to play fetch? Give me a minute, okay? The cat wants to play fetch. And the last prompt engineering tip I want to give you before we get into the five-part formula is to format the result. Let your LLM know how to format the response in order to get the best output. We're going to see this again in the five-part formula, so here's what I mean. Instead of saying something like, I want to design a logo for my community library, give Gemini or your LLM of your choosing the format. So instead I'm going to say, draft a design brief for my community library's new logo. So now I've let it know that I want a design brief as the format for this prompt. Now, of course, with any of these examples we just saw, we can go into a lot more detail with our prompts. And that's where our five-part prompt formula comes into play. This is going to change the way you prompt your LLM. So here's how the formula breaks down. First, you're going to give a role. Then you want to define a goal. You're going to specify the audience. You're going to set your restrictions or style or tone. And then you're going to, like we just saw, format the result. So giving a role to your LLM is not a necessity, but it is a nice to have. Who is your LLM trying to be, and what sort of things are they great at? If you could talk to an expert in whatever field, pretend that's your LLM and assign that role. So think things like your nutritionist, you're a 10th grade Spanish teacher, act like a world-renowned magician, you're an accountant with 20 years experience. You get the idea here. The second part of our 5-prompt formula is to define the goal. Now, this is an essential part of your prompt that you should never skip. To define the goal, you're gonna start with a verb or command and briefly describe the specific task. You can add instructions here and additional tasks if needed and any necessary context. So some examples could be things like write an essay, code a web page, create a weekly meal plan, brainstorm 10 ideas for XYZ, and fill in the blank. This is something you cannot skip when you are prompting your LLM. Next in our prompt formula is to specify the audience. This is another nice to have in your prompt. When you're specifying your audience, this is gonna help your LLM tailor responses based on who it's intended for. So for this, I want you to think things like for an 8th grader, or for people who speak English as a second language, or for corporate executives. Maybe it's for people with no coding experience, etc. Another helpful part of your prompt is to set restrictions, style, or tone. So again, this is not a necessity, but this is really gonna help you get more nuanced, detailed responses. So when you're setting restrictions or style or tone notes, get specific on how you want the output to feel based on your goals. So if you were writing a sonnet, you might add something like in the style of a Shakespearean sonnet. Or maybe you're writing a cover letter, you may ask for a short professional tone, or you may want your LLM to cite scientific sources only. These are all things that would fall under restrictions, style, and tone. The last part of this 5-part prompt formula is to format the result, like we just saw in an earlier example. I honestly think this can be an essential part of your prompt. As we learn, to format the result, you're gonna tell your LLM how it might format the output to make it actionable. So this could be as simple as answer with bullet points, answer with a numbered list, provide a paragraph summary, put it in a chart, and so on. So this is so helpful, and I am telling you, it will save you so much time. So now let's put this 5-part prompt formula together with a couple of examples. And let's start with saying, maybe I want a high protein, plant-based weekly meal plan. And we'll start with that and build a detailed prompt from there. Starting with our role, I'll say, you're a nutritionist. So now let's define the goal. Show me a high protein, plant-based weekly meal plan with recipes that can be made in under 30 minutes. So now let's specify the audience. This plan is for an active woman in her 30s who's trying to build muscle. Now let's try a restriction here for fun. Do not include avocados in the meal plan. So remember, this is where you can add a restriction, your style, or tone notes if you wanted. It's not required. Now let's end this prompt with a format request. I'm gonna say, put this plan in a chart by meal and day of the week. Now this is one detailed prompt. Holy moly. So check out what Gemini is giving me here. At the top, we've got important considerations based on my detailed prompt. Underneath that, we've got the detailed meal plan chart by day of the week and meal of breakfast, lunch, and dinner, just like I asked. And underneath that, we've even got the corresponding recipes. So you can see how incredible this is when you're adding in all that rich detail. Now, if only Gemini could go grocery shopping for me. But let's try one more example for good measure, just to make sure we really nail this prompt formula. All right, let's say, you're a sports history writer. Write a 1-page article on the Montreal Canadiens' unlikely 2021 Stanley Cup run and how vastly different their season is now. This article is geared towards knowledgeable sports fans, so write it in an engaging but professional tone. Include a headline, a byline, and up to 5 paragraphs for the body of the article. All right, so we can see here that I've got the role, I've defined the goal, and I've specified the audience. I've set the tone, and I've asked for this format. And not bad at all. It has included a headline. No byline though, interestingly enough. Maybe I could ask for that again in a follow-up like we learned earlier. But here we go. Oh man, this is actually gonna make me really sad. Okay, it's generated 5 paragraphs like I've asked for, and it's even pulled in some great details here too. I love it. So hopefully you found these prompt engineering tips helpful and you've learned how to prompt an LLM. So if you did find this helpful, I'd love for you to let me know by giving this video a like or leaving a comment below. Remember, you can watch even more videos on Gemini and AI by clicking up here, and you can subscribe to my channel by clicking right about here. Thanks for watching. See you next time.